By 1496, Ferdinand and Isabella had abandoned all hope of earning a fast profit through Columbus's ventures. Nevertheless, the explorer was able to convince the monarchs to agree to a third voyage. Five ships were provided, carrying 300 men and 30 women who would settle in the colonies, as well as provisions to be delivered to Hispaniola. On the 31st of July, 1498, Columbus discovered the island of Trinidad, entered the Gulf of Paria, and discovered the mouth of the western branch of the Orinoco Delta and the Paria Peninsula. This event marked the beginning of the discovery of South America. Entering the Caribbean, he approached the Araya Peninsula, discovered the island of Margarita on August the 15th, and reached Haiti on August 31st. But a heavy blow was awaiting Columbus at Hispaniola. Due to denunciations and their fear that Columbus might strive to become supreme ruler of the newly discovered lands, the treacherous Spanish rulers sent a ship whose crew was ordered to apprehend Columbus. In 1500, the explorer was sent to Castile in shackles. It took Columbus nearly 2 years to prove his innocence, and eventually his rights were returned. But despite that, another man was sent to head the next expedition. Nicolas de Ovando was declared governor of Hispaniola and set sail for the Caribbean in February 1502, commanding 30 ships with a large group of settlers. Despite all this, in March 1502, Ferdinand and Isabella let Columbus head a new transatlantic expedition.
Thank you. Thank you.